Hey there! Sometimes when people hear my accent, they ask me where I am from. And then I tell them that I am from Latvia, but I live in North Carolina, the United States. And very often then they ask, Latvia? Where is that? I've never heard of that country. And that's kind of sad. But on the other hand, how many Latvians know where North Carolina is? Not many. If they had to point it on the map, not many of them could find it. So I have decided to simply talk more about Latvia so that more people know about it. But first, if you don't know me, I'll introduce myself. I am Ilze Be, I am a Latvian and I teach Latvian for English speakers. And if you have ever considered learning Latvian, perhaps you have looked through internet and you have seen online videos where Latvian is taught. And usually there are lessons about counting. I can even guess that perhaps you have tried learning how to count in Latvian. Viens, divi, trīs, četri, pieci. It sounds quite simple, doesn't it? But why then people say that learning Latvian is difficult? Well, first of all, I would like to prove otherwise, but I'll explain why that is. You need to know that it's not enough to know viens, divi, trīs, četri, pieci, because it will not fit in all situations. For instance, if you wanted to count girls, you wouldn't say viens meitene, divi meitene, trīs meitene, četri meitene. That wouldn't be right. You would have to say viena meitene, divas meitenes, trīs meitenes, četras meitenes. It wouldn't be also correct to say sveiks to me. Sveiks stands for hi, but it is not appropriate to greet a woman by saying sveiks. You would say sveika, or the safest way is to greet by saying sveiki, because that is a plural form and that's how you address people who you don't know well. So I have created a small course which is called Colors, Numbers and Family Members, where I teach to speak sentences under these three topics: colors, numbers and family members. And in this course I'm teaching to say color words, number words, and to talk about the relationships between family members using correct forms of words. And the bigger purpose for me by creating this course was to show my students that Latvian is figure-outable. It's not actually that difficult to understand how word forms change in Latvian if you have clear instructions, and I give those instructions. I'm pricing this course at only $10 because I want people to have a chance to decide if Latvian is the language for them to learn. So if you have tried to learn Latvian and if you have gone through all the free courses and you want to proceed and learn something more, I invite you to join me in this course. If you'd like to learn more about what it means to learn Latvian, go to my website ilzeb.com and find my blog post, Learning Latvian Requires Some Shift in Thinking. And this is also the answer to the question that I had in the title of this video: what learning Latvian requires.